before.
No, no,
I get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before.
No, no,
I get a good feeling, yeah.
Yes, I can. Doubt to believe I'm one of his plan.
Welcome to the AHS News in 2012. I'm Miranda Lane.
I'm Monica Rangel, and welcome to new semester as well.
A new year means new resolutions, new outlooks, rebirths, reinventions, and changes.
The new year gives us a chance to change our hearts, our minds, our bodies, and even our souls.
This edition of the AHS News brings you changes and transformations. We're already celebrating in the halls of Aynor High in 2012.
Kylan Raven brings a story about the changing hearts, minds, bodies, and souls here at AHS.
Books have been written about it, movies have been made about it, and the new year always seems to inspire people to make changes about it. What is it? The heart, mind, body, soul connection. It's believed that each of these work together to help make you the best person you can be. As 2012 changed on the calendar, people began making resolutions to improve one or more of these areas in their life. Which would you choose to improve and how would you do it? It's a tough question and we went straight to the Psychology and Theory of Knowledge class of Miss Nikki Batson to her students. What would they change and how would they do it?
The aspect that I would like to change about my life would be my mind, because everybody starts to think about the negative before they think about the positive, and being optimistic would create me to have a better lifespan, and it would help me keep my body and my soul and my heart. So therefore I'd have to change my mind before I change anything and being optimistic.
I would change my mind by increasing my knowledge, by reading books and getting away from technology, so that way I can make my mind stronger.
I would change my heart by being more trustworthy in myself and being more trustworthy in other people, so I know my limits in life and in school and at home.
The thing that I would change is my mind, because I would do that by questioning the decisions that I make. You know, being at the age that I am, I demand a lot of, you know, decisions that will affect, you know, possibly the rest of my life. And I need to start thinking about the repercussions of those decisions I make. And so I want to be able to, I feel like I would do better thinking about the decisions and effects of it.
If I could change one thing, I would probably change my mind, and I would do that by being more organized and understanding my responsibilities.
Whether you choose to improve your mind, your body, your heart, or your soul, make a choice to be better than you were. Make the 2012 year your best year yet. This is Kylan for the AHS News.
Thanks, Kylan. New Year makeovers and reinventions aren't always about people. Here's Becca Sarvis to take us through a page-by-page journey in this new edition of Bling Your Binder.
Mic check. Yeah, here you go. Oh, nah, he over here. Yeah, I heard he got that hot new thing. It's called
Switch.
Let's get it going.
Also, when they may have it together in the classroom, but you couldn't tell by his binder. AHS News, could you bling Austin Wyndham's binder?
Don't worry, Zach. We got your buddy covered, and we will bling his binder.
Yo, mic check. Yeah, here you go. Oh, nah, he over here. Yeah, I heard he got that hot new thing. It's called
Switch.
If you've ever noticed Austin Wyndham around the halls of Aynor High School, you probably notice he's on the quiet side and doesn't create much of a fuss. He keeps himself low on the radar and saves his passion for the fields and courts where he plays on both the JV football and basketball teams. He seems to have it all together. What's not together is his binder. To help him get it together, his binder makeover requires some basic upgrades on looks, organization, and heavy-duty cleanup. Austin's pretty simple with his taste. As the Aynor Blue Jackets and Duke Blue Devils are his teams, now that we've got this freshman together, let's hope he keeps it together.
Thanks, Becca. Good luck with your new and blinged out binder, Austin.
And speaking of a little bling, we go to commercial break now and feature a new business in Aynor that's providing a few makeovers of their own.
We'll be right back.
It seems like everybody is headed to Classy Lassie, the new pet grooming salon in downtown Aynor. Whether your pet needs some pampering with feather extensions, hair coloring, or nail painting, or just a plain good old-fashioned bath, Classy Lassie offers experienced and well-trained grooming expertise at reasonable rates. You'll love the attention and care your pet receives, and they'll like it too. For an appointment or more information, call 843-605-2916 and let your pet start 2012 off with a fresh new look. Located on 8th Avenue across from Anderson Brothers Bank, join the rush to get to Classy Lassie.
You know what, Miranda? I wonder how my poodle would look with purple feathers.
Not sure I can help you with the purple, but Whitmer Cocking can tell us about our athletes in blue.
It's on the athletic scene that 2012 is already bringing us success with the heart and soul of winter sports.
Welcome to Winters in Sports with Wyatt. This show is about our athletes, our teams, and their achievements, successes, and victories, even if the scoreboard doesn't always come out in our favor. But on this segment of Winners in Sports, I'm proud to feature our region champion wrestling team.
It's been 9 years since the Blue Jackets have won the region championship in wrestling. The wrestling team has had an impressive season so far by going undefeated in region matches and having a 19-7 record. Next Saturday, the Blue Jacket wrestling team will travel to Hanahan High School for the Lower State Team Championship, where the Blue Jackets are seated first, and they will get a chance to go all the way and have their first team state title. Ethan Nobles thinks that the wrestling team has a good chance to win state.
Our chances this year as becoming the state champions as a team, we're actually doing pretty good as of right now. We're seated number one in lower state. Going into lower state, we're seated number one, which is basically the first rank.
To wrap up this segment of Winners in Sports, the Aynor JV basketball teams have done a good job with their seasons as well. The boys' JV team has had a 4-8 season and just lost a very close game to Marion on Monday. The girls' JV team is the first girls' JV team we have had in 2 years. They have had a good season, but also lost on Monday night. The varsity basketball teams have done very well this season with the boys' record of 3-12. They have lost 8 games within 7 points in the last 3 minutes of the game. The girls' team has a record of 7-10, and they have had a very good season also. Good job, Blue Jackets, and keep the wins coming in.
Thanks, Wyatt, and keep the good things happening, Blue Jackets.
The new year will bring changes not only to those of AHS, but to people of all cultures, all faiths, and all regions of the world.
What's going on around the world? Quentin Gore introduces a new segment that keeps you alert to what's on the global radar.
I'm Quentin. On the Radar is a new series that's going to locate and identify information that is current, newsworthy, and relevant. What's on the radar now? 2012. Right here, right now, all over the world.
Here in the U.S., we've already seen the ball drop. We've made New Year's resolutions, and if you were at my house, we ate home-cooked food and plenty of it. My family should be in good shape for 2012, but what about the other families in other parts of the world? In India, 2012 is being considered the golden age and is expected to bring good fortune. Although China is going to celebrate the Year of the Dragon, this medieval icon is also supposed to bring them great success and happiness this year. The Mayan culture, an ancient Mesoamerican civilization that has very few descendants left in our world today, has an outlook that isn't so great. This historic culture believed that 2012 would feature the last day of our times, which is December 21st, 2012. But wait, there is some good news. The Mayans never completed the calendar. It just happened to stop on December 21st, 2012.
You know what? I say we live every day as if it's our last. That's good advice for any culture in any year. See you next time on the Radar with Quinn.
Thanks, Quentin. We look forward to what's on your radar next time.
And what's on the musical charts right now? Chris Hunes brings us a brand new AH1.
Jay Sean. 2012. Nicki Minaj. Yeah. Yeah. It's alright. Oh, it's alright. You know what they say. Life ain't always easy, and every day we're survivors. Don't forget today. It's all about tonight. Act a fool and start a riot. For riot, be a rebel.
Rock until 6 a.m. New York to London, over to Japan.
Turn it up, turn it up, mash it up.
We gonna party like,
party like,
like it's the end of the world.
We gonna party like,
like it's 2012.
You know that it doesn't matter as long as we got each other. Turn it up.
Hey, Jesse. Big
get this day anymore. And it's never too late to start living. So let's start it with right here and right now.
Party like, it's the end of the world. We're gonna party like, it's 2012. You know that it doesn't matter as long as we got each other. Turn it up.
There's nothing like music to stir the soul.
As we close this broadcast, we encourage you to stay on that journey of change and growth during 2012. Keep your hearts, minds, bodies, and souls focused.
And speaking of hearts, we give a nod to the upcoming Valentine's Day with these secret admirer wishes.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. I get a feeling that never had before.
No, no,
I get a good feeling, yeah.
The mountaintop, walk on water. I got power, feel so royal. 1 second, I'ma strike oil. Diamond, platinum, no more oil. That is to the land, never giving in. Giving up is not an option, gotta get it in. Witness, I got the heart of 20 men. No fear, go to sleep in the lion's den. That flow, that spark, that crown. You're looking at the king of the jungle now. Stronger than ever, can't hold me down. 100 miles gunning from the pitcher's mound. Straight game face, it's game day. See me running through the crowd for the melee. No trick plays, I'm Bill Gates. Take a genius to understand me.
Sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before.
No, no.